Item number SCP-433. Object class Euclid. Special containment procedure. Only one copy of instructions for performing SCP-433 is permitted to exist at any given time. As well, the complete procedures may never be placed in an electronic document in order to reduce the risk of containment breach. Dr. Severe and Dr. have each read half of document SCP-433-001. They may not transcribe or share the contained information with anyone, including each other, without O5 approval. In the event that information regarding the procedures necessary for SCP-433 is leaked, a disinformation campaign is to be undertaken immediately. As well, all facilities capable of producing plutonium-238 are to be closely monitored for thefts or increased production. Description: SCP-433 is a ritual described in document SCP-433-001. The ritual, when performed, results in the wholesale replacement of all matter within 11 meters of the center of the ritual. All people, objects, terrain, and even gas is apparently removed and replaced with matter of unknown origin. Document SCP-433-001 is contained within a large tome found in Russia. The tome appears to be a grimoire of rituals, all written in Latin. The grimoire was discovered next to a spherical crater 22 meters in diameter, left open to document SCP-433-001. Due to the strange nature of the circumstances surrounding its discovery, the Foundation confiscated the grimoire and filled the crater. All rituals described in the grimoire were tested. However, only SCP-433 yielded any result. It is worth noting that the majority of the rituals described in the grimoire contained one or more unknown symbols that could not be translated. SCP-433 was one of only three that did not. The grimoire itself is printed on normal paper and bound in leather, and displays no anomalous properties. Some of the materials required for SCP-433 include 3 human skulls, tin, potassium nitrate, ice, a coil of copper wire, plutonium-238. Note: Dr. The need for plutonium-238 is something of a blessing in disguise. Even if knowledge of SCP-433 were to be leaked, the difficulty of acquisition means very few would be capable of performing it. This is the translated text at the top of document SCP-433-001, describing SCP-433. Should the need arise to flee, and you find yourself sapped of unknown symbols, do not despair. The dance of unknown symbols will guide you to safety. Be warned, even the unknown symbols may perform the dance of unknown symbols. Do not let them into our home. Test log 433031. Test 433-1. This was the first attempt at performing the ritual detailed within SCP-433. All instructions were followed precisely by Dr. and several junior researchers. In the video log, which has since been destroyed, the instant the final step of the ritual was performed, a loud crash can be heard, and the entire ritual area, including Dr. and his assistants, vanished. The area was instantly replaced by a large spherical block of stone. Analysis reveals the stone to be made of ordinary granite, with no detectable anomalies in its composition. Neither Dr. nor his assistants have been located. By order of O5, all further testing with SCP-433 must be performed using Class D personnel only. Test 433-2. SCP-433 is performed by Data Expunged Class D personnel. Upon activation, the ritual area and all participants vanished, leaving behind a section of dirt of roughly the same dimensions. The dirt was dark purple in color and contained several plants of unknown species. Analysis of the air revealed it to have apparently been replaced as well. Gas samples taken revealed the nitrogen and methane concentrations in the room to have increased by 5% and 2% respectively, while the oxygen concentration dropped by 6%. The actual concentrations in the replaced air are theorized to have been of a greater difference than that, due to the mixing of the gases upon completion of the ritual. Tests 433-3, 433-4, 433-5, and 433-6. Several attempts at performing SCP-433 were made, while using slightly varied procedures and items than listed in Document 433-1. Test 433-3. Plutonium-238 replaced with plutonium-239. No result. Test 433-4. One human skull is replaced with the skull of an orangutan. No result. Test 433-5. Step 7 is omitted from the ritual. No result. Test 433-6. Expunged individuals, instead of expunged, are included in the ritual area. SCP-433 activates successfully. The ritual area is removed, but no solid matter replaces it. Instead, the entire ritual area is replaced by gas of concentration similar to those from Test 433-2. Test 433-7. Ritual performed successfully, following exact procedures outlined in Document 433-1. Ritual area is replaced by a sand-water salt mixture, similar but not identical in composition to that of ocean water. Several fish-like creatures of unknown species are brought as well. The creatures expired shortly after arriving. Dissection of the creatures, despite being interesting from a biological standpoint, yielded no useful information as to the nature of SCP-433. Test 433-8. Ritual performed successfully, following exact procedures outlined in Document 433-1. Upon activation, the ritual area was replaced with a half-sphere composed of a dark brown clay. Standing in the center of the circle was a previously unknown creature, hereby designated SCP-433-1. While vaguely humanoid in appearance, it possessed several chitin-like plates covering various parts of its body. SCP-433-1 was approximately 3 meters tall, with gray skin, and no discernible eyes or mouth. For approximately 6 seconds after SCP-433-1 appeared, all personnel in the area reported vividly seeing a rapid succession of images, after the conclusion of which SCP-433-1 raised its arms and vanished. With it vanished the entire area that had been transferred. The original ritual area then reappeared, complete with terrain, objects, and participants. All ritual participants, without exception, had been dismembered. Legs, arms, and heads were separated from their respective bodies via perfectly smooth, clean cuts. As well, the data expunged at the center of the ritual circle had been shattered. All personnel reported the images to be as follows. A group of nude humans appearing to perform SCP-433. Several Foundation personnel reported that all humans in the images were identical to one another. A human skeleton, with an instance of SCP-433-1 standing over it. A large modern city, believed to be lying in ruins. The night side of the Earth as seen from space. No lights are evident. None of the affected individuals reported any lasting effects from the experience. Addendum 433-1. Due to the results of Test 433-8, and by consent of O5 and Dr., all testing on SCP-433 has been suspended indefinitely. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, Go watch SCP-432, Cabinet Maze, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.